quizzes. A quiz is a form of game or mind sport in which a player, in our case, you the viewer, will attempt to answer questions correctly. And why is it that I am so happy today? Because I will be asking the questions, and that is always much more fun than answering the questions, except when one knows all the right answers, because in that case, one feels really good. Today, I am pretty sure many of you will experience a level 10 pleasure because you have the right answers to our questions about the first round of the 5 W's of behavioral neuroscience. Hey, did you notice I said the 5 W's and not the 5 Y's? Someone is learning the alphabet. Okay, let's start with our first questions. Hey guys, would you mind if I ask Bobby for help? Bobby, can you help me here? I will ask some questions to our friends and you let them know the right answer in case they don't know, okay? Deal? Thank you. Ready? Go. Who is Santiago, Ramón y Cajal? 1, 2, or 3? Hey Bobby, tell our friends. Very well. Next, what could you do to challenge your brain areas in charge of motor control? Sleep, juggling, or socialize? Go, Bobby. Good. Next one. In which picture you can find an individual with XX chromosomes? 1, 2, or 3? You try, Bobby? No, no. Chickens have chromosomes Z and W, no X and Y. Okay, try again. Well, Bobby, one last opportunity. There you go. This is a female spotted hyena. One more question. Which of the pictures show a clear example of extrinsic reward? Bobby, do you have this one? Excellent, Bobby. The pleasure experience of money has to be conditioned in humans. Last question. Which one is the brain of Homo sapiens? Bobby, can you answer? Very well indeed. Thank you, Bobby. My dear friends, I hope all of you did very well in this first quiz. But if you are the kind of people that understand the value of being challenged and is not afraid of taking quizzes, I have another one just for you. But before I show you the quiz, let me summarize this first round of the 5 W's of behavioral neuroscience. Today, we are wrapping up our 2020 round of our first playlist, the 5 W's of behavioral neuroscience. The main intention with this summary is to help you review the main concepts we covered in these 5 videos so that you could make more sense of them and better understand how they connect to each other. The quiz will come at the end. I am pretty sure you will feel proud in sharing your answers with us and much more in finding out that you did excellent in our quiz. But first, let's have our disclaimers out of the way. Number one, it makes me happy if you learn something with our videos, and I would really appreciate if you let me know in the comments when you learn something new. Number two, this is the last video of our round 2020. So if you want me to take into account your suggestions on topics about brain and behavior for 2021, consider leaving a comment below any of the videos in the playlist. And number three, you, my friends, have written many messages of support about how much you already appreciate the channel and the potential value that it could have for the community. Your messages, comments, likes, and cheer have made me and Bobby very happy. So, thank you. These are the thumbnails of the first videos in the playlist. How is it that these topics could relate to each other? Let's see. Who? I believe that it is important to talk about the people behind human knowledge. We take so many things for granted, frequently without realizing the men and women that devoted their entire life to generate that knowledge for the rest of us. That is the reason behind the Who video that you can find up here. In behavioral neuroscience, everything starts with the brain. Do you know that the Bible mentions the heart, the liver, and the stomach hundreds of times, but never, never mentions the brain? You know why? Because nobody knew the importance of the brain in those times when the Bible was written. But when Cajal came along, he was instrumental in making us understand the workings of the brain. He described the neurons, drew thousands of neuronal circuits in the brain, and even called kisses those points of contact between neurons. Definitely the poetic way to refer to synapses. And the science righteous champion also understood that the brain was not immutable, that in fact it could be reshaped, and that the change of the brain happens constantly. You can watch What is Brain Building in the link coming now. The hashtag of the 2020 What video was neuroplasticity. But I decided to make up the word brain building to emphasize the fact that you, me, and everybody else can direct, to some extent, the reshaping of the brain. My friends, this is not mere theory. Your brain is changing right now, and my brain is changing right now. From 1 second to the next, a small but continuous change. And if you challenge your brain in a smart way, that change will very likely favor and better your life, and the life of your kids and your grandkids. And that is because we are mainly our brain, my friends, much more than we are our heart, our liver, or our stomach. My advice, if you have to make an effort to foster some body part, make it for your brain more than for your muscles. Now, we cannot change all of our brain at will, and our When video here can help us understand that. I decided to talk about biological sex in our first round because I find it necessary in 2020. The conversation around biological sex, gender, and sexual orientation is pertinent today more than before. We need, in my opinion, to understand how is it that sex is developed all along life, starting in the womb and ending in the tomb. The more we learn about it, the more we will appreciate the diversity of human sex, sexual identity, and sexual orientation. Do you remember that we talked about androgen insensitivity syndrome? The intersex condition of Han, Gabby, Odile, and many other women? Their bodies have XY chromosomes and testes, like the bodies of men. But their cells do not respond to the testosterone produced by their testes, aka androgen insensitivity. In consequence, when there is complete androgen insensitivity syndrome, the rest of the body develops as the body of women with breasts, vulva, and vagina. And especially their brains develop as the brain of women. So they have a heterosexual female gender identity. So much of who we are when it comes to gender and sexual orientation is decided for us during the development of our brains. We do not decide, in most cases, which gender we identify with or which sex we feel attracted to. And the many alternatives we find in everyday life are all variations of the extraordinary human sexual biology. Now, when talking about brain changes, modifications, or conditions, we need to recognize that a large percentage of those take place in the trillions of neuronal synapses we have in the brain. An excellent example can be found in this video about the effects of cocaine on our brains. First, cocaine will block the dopamine transporters and trigger an incredible increase in pleasure. But once the brain responds by removing the dopamine receptors out of the postsynaptic membrane, cocaine would have accomplished the stealing of your pleasure. And all that happens at the synapse. And this downregulation is a clear example of a mechanism that evolved during millions of years to keep the balance of our emotions and feelings right in the range where they are of advantage to us. During these millions of years, our brains were, very probably, also changing significantly from generation to generation to become the ones our species have today. As I explained in this video. And in that process, the discovery of fire and cooking may have played a decisive role. As a consequence of a soft and calorie-rich cooked diet, we reduced significantly our chewing time. And therefore, cooking gave us the energy and the free time to feed our brains and develop our human culture. All of that we have covered in our first playlist. If you miss any video, I suggest you to watch it. Especially now that we go into quiz time. But first, the instructions. Number one, find the quiz down in the description of the video, both in English and Spanish. Number two, if you feel your brain burning while you are answering the quiz, it may be because the challenge is working. Number three, write your answers down in the comments and use the format 1C, 2A, 3D, 4B, etc. But remember, these are not the real answers, just an example. And finally, four, we will reveal the right answers once this video makes it to 1,000 views to give some time for our friends to try the quiz. Finally, remember that this is an open video quiz. So if you need it, feel free to go watch the videos again. That's it, my friends. Thank you for your company during our first playlist. Hey, Bobby, do you want to close the round with me? Dear friends, please stay safe and God bless you.